الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد. Respected viewers, brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Sadh Guru Jaggi Vasudev is a famous Indian Swami and Yogi who has been teaching yoga in southern India since 1982 and after it in 1992 he established Isha Foundation near Coimbatore, which runs an ashram, hosts a yoga center. Sadhguru often comes up on social media and expresses his views on various topics comprising spirituality, education and the environment. A few days ago, his video, namely, Sadhguru reveals the hidden power of the triangle, appeared on YouTube, in which he disclosed the hidden power and secrets behind the triangle of human body and also of the buildings and other things made in the shape of triangle, etc. I agree to his thoughts, but I want to disclose here about another unique triangle of human being, that is his life triangle, and that he never comes out of it in his whole life. As the picture of a triangle shows that the people pass their lives remaining within their three wishes, it means eating, drinking and fulfilling their sexual desire. Routine life of man goes on as the people get up early in the morning and after relieving from their needs, they have breakfast and then go to their daily work, business or services, etc. And at evening, they return back to their homes and have dinner, while some people go to hotels or to other places for entertainment. After returning back, they go to their beds. And meanwhile, the married couples fulfill their sexual desire, and then after night, again it is morning, and this process sets in motion from anew. This is mankind's life triangle, that he or she never comes out of it. He strives to have best accommodation, to marriage, to arrange delicious and healthy food, and to marry to a beautiful spouse. And this is the goal of his life. Now I come to the point, Allah Almighty has never created man only for eating, drinking or to fulfill his natural wishes like the beasts, but he has created man for a particular purpose. It means to worship of him. And as regards man's sustenance and other needs of life, so Allah Almighty himself is responsible for them, as the Holy Quran reveals. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون ما أريد منهم من رزق وما أريد أن يطعمون إن الله هو الرزاق ذو القوة المتين صدق الله العظيم. I created the jinn and mankind only that they might worship me. I seek no livelihood from them, nor do I ask that they should feed me. Lo, Allah, He is that gives livelihood, the Lord of unbreakable might. These verses reveal that Allah alone is responsible for man's all needs of life, including his sustenance, and he has been created the man only for his worship. And the worship means here act upon all of Allah's commands according to the good example of the Holy Prophet, may peace and mercy of Allah be upon him. Because some of the followers of the Hinduism say that we also do worship of Allah, the Ishwar, but you call him Rahim and we call him Ram or Rama. The main idea of this speech is that the man should come out of his life triangle, and besides eating, drinking and fulfilling his other natural necessities, he or she should also consider on something more. It means about to make his life better, this worldly life, and also the life of the hereafter. Because only the religion of Islam gives guarantee of the salvation and the success of this world and also of life of the hereafter. May Allah give us tawfiq to accept the religion of Islam and to act upon all the command of Allah Almighty. Ameen. وما علينا إلا البلاغ المبين.